Good day. So today we're talking about how to bring content straight. If you are new to our YouTube page, please do subscribe down below, drop your comment, and like our videos. We got a comment from a subscriber on our YouTube page where he said, if we could tell him more about how the Supreme Court operates. We're not talking much about the structures of the Supreme Court. We're talking more about how it actually does operate. So talk about the Supreme Court. We have to look at who is actually the head of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is headed by the Chief Justice of Nigeria. The Chief Justice of Nigeria is also the head of all judiciary in Nigeria. The CJN is appointed by the President on recommendation of the National Judicial Council and on confirmation of the Senate, which is actually a simple majority. Now, for other justices of the Supreme Court, just the appointment of the President and recommendation from the National Judicial Council. So let's talk about the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. What is the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court? Yeah, we're simply talking about the kind of matters or cases the Supreme Court handles. They are divided into two. We have regional jurisdiction and appellate jurisdiction. What is the regional jurisdiction of the Supreme Court? The regional jurisdiction of the Supreme Court is simply saying that these are the original cases the Supreme Court handles to the exclusion of any other court. The Supreme Court handles this at first instance. These are the five regional jurisdictions of the Supreme Court. Any matter that involves any of the parties just mentioned above goes originally to the Supreme Court. So let's talk about the appellate jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. Any appeal from the Court of Appeal goes straight to the Supreme Court. That is simply what the appellate jurisdiction of the Supreme Court is talking about. So let's talk about the constitution of the Supreme Court. How do they sit? The Supreme Court sits in five. That means five justices of the Supreme Court sit on a usual day. Why? But it's what they call a full house. A full house is when seven justices of the Supreme Court will be sitting. You have about three instances this will happen. One, when they are sitting in their original jurisdiction. Now, just remember, like I said, the five cases they are supposed to sit in the original jurisdiction. At that point, they'll be sitting in seven. That means you're having seven justices sitting on their bench. Secondly, when there's a case that has to do with constitution or interpretation of the constitution, they'll be sitting in seven. Finally, when that's to do with interpretation of a fundamental human right of a person, they'll be sitting in seven. So these are the three instances the Supreme Court to be sitting in their full house. So to put that JSC once said, we are final not because we are in for labor. We are in for labor because we are final. Now, this code brings to the finality of the decision of the Supreme Court. The decision of the Supreme Court is final. However, in rare cases, they can overrule themselves.